Welcome back, and we're here at SunGlow still, and we're inside the house, which is inside the building. Sounds like a Dr. Seuss joke. But Tracy, we're going to flood this house as sort of means of a demonstration. Why don't you lead this discussion, talk about what goes on inside here.
We've got various different points where disasters happen.
Right.
Our sprinkler head goes off. We've got broken pipes in the walls.
Okay.
We've got washing machines that flood. Bathrooms, and so
and it's remarkable. I mean, you said 50 times this place has been flooded. I mean, this carpet looks almost brand new.
We have different types of materials in the house so that we can see different types of carpeting. We have on this side, we have commercial grade, residential grade carpet.
Yep.
We've got Berber in the bedrooms. We've got hardwood floors, we've got linoleum, ceramic tile.
And this furniture, it's all gotten wet. I mean, everything that's in here is gotten wet before.
Been wet and dried a number of times.
Okay. And the walls are kind of interesting too, what you've got set up in here. Can you explain a little bit of this?
We use equipment called Octodries that are put into the walls that will dry inside the wall cavities.
Okay.
The holes in the walls are for equipment that we use to dry the wall cavities.
Okay.
A lot of people think that the carpeting would be something that would need to be
pulled up.
It's not necessarily pulled up.
Okay.
We can dry in place, but we really want to concentrate on the building, the structure.
Mm-hmm.
When you dry the walls, then the carpet and everything inside of it will naturally dry along with it.
Now, there's holes in these baseboards, but I think you told me that's more or less for demonstration purposes, but do you take the baseboards off first and then kind of drill holes? Or
if we were actually in someone's home, that's how we would do it. We would remove the baseboards.
Okay.
We would put the holes in.
Okay.
We would inject the air into the wall cavities to make sure that that portion gets nice and dry.
Yep.
And then when we're finished, we'll reattach the base and cover the little holes that we put in there.
How long, typically, would it take to dry a wall versus carpeting or furniture? Is it all the same time?
We are pretty confident that we can dry almost any structure within 3 days.
Okay.
There are some issues, maybe vapor barriers, a wall that maybe had wallpaper on it may dry a little bit slower than a painted wall. So we keep all of that into consideration when we send our crews in and establish a drying plan.
Okay. Let's walk and talk a little bit about more or less what we've got going on in here. Talk about this room. This is more of the pantry, I guess, or not the pantry, but the breakfast nook area. And what have we got going on here as far as the walls?
This area here, we can demonstrate how much airflow we're getting into the walls. With the little flags on it, we'll be able to see which equipment works better.
Yeah.
We also, the wood floor, we've had this, like I said, 50 times it's been flooded. If you are able to dry it correctly, you won't get any cupping or crowning of the floor. So the floor is, it's still in good condition, just would need a refinishing, which is much easier for homeowners, insurance companies to deal with. It's less expensive to refinish it than to replace it.
Take us down the hall a little bit and talk about what we've got more or less going on around here. And I, you know, it's got its own thermostat. I mean, this is really a real house.
Self-contained. We have its own electricity, its own air conditioning, heating and cooling. Everything runs in the house.
Yep.
Here we have our Berber carpet,
mm-hmm.
Which dries a little bit differently than a plush wood. We've got different pads underneath too.
Okay.
So we can see a 6 pound versus an 8 pound pad. So there's other things underneath that we don't necessarily see.
And again, original padding, I mean, still got the cushion to it and whatnot.
We also have an area here which simulates a crawl space.
Okay.
We have a lot of homes that are built on crawl spaces, and sometimes when the main level is flooded, it will go into the crawl space. So this is just helping us dry the dirt, the sand, whatever is underneath the home. We address that as well and make sure that is dry.
This home sets you apart from a lot of different other, I would imagine, restoration places. I mean, it's such multi use that could be used for this. Obviously, you use it a lot for certification purposes, and you mentioned demonstration. Do you use this a lot with, you know, sort of businesses that are trying to, I mean, really, business wouldn't need you until the problem happens, correct?
Correct.
So it's not something where you would want to pull a business in and go, if you were ever to get flooded.
But we do a lot of things in the community that make people aware of us just in case the disaster happens.
Okay.
The certification that comes along with this building is something that we're very proud of. Okay. Buildings like this, there are roughly 14 of them in the United States, and we are certified as an applied structural drying facility. And that is the pinnacle in our industry of the certifications that you can have. So we are able to instruct our own people that work mm-hmm. here in the science of drying, okay. as well as we invite other people in the industry to come and learn at this facility.
You mentioned science of drying, and then that would lead me into really the technological aspects of what you guys do. How often does that change within this industry?
We have updated manuals and guidelines mm-hmm. probably every 2 years.
Does the equipment change much, though?
There's always improvements.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So it does. We are definitely evolving
okay.
as an industry.
Why don't we walk outside and wrap up our show, and as everyone can see all the demonstrations going on while we're talking, and let's finish up outside.
Great.
Tracy, thanks for showing me this. This is really neat. Something not everybody gets to see, but certainly now with the wonders of television, folks will be able to see this.
We're glad that you were able to come out today. In addition to the training facility, I just wanted to take a minute to make sure that I mention all of the things that are great about SunGlow. We have a fleet of roughly 40 vehicles.
Right.
We service all of Southeast Michigan as well as Northern Ohio. We are a company that's available 24/7,
sure.
holidays, weekends, evenings, we respond. So that makes us very proud.
And for folks that would like to learn more about SunGlow, you've got a website?
Yes, we do. Our website is sunglowservices.com.
Okay.
And there's lots of information about the specific services that we offer. We have our class schedules. You're able to contact us if you have an emergency.
Great.
So it's a really nice website, and we'd like everyone to visit that as well.
Great. Thank you, Tracy. We're out of time, but I appreciate you hosting us today. And with that, that's the end of another wonderful episode of Corporate Review. If you'd like more information on economic development, doing business in Novi, we invite you to go to investnovi.org. Thank you.